Hi, I'm Paul Sturrock. I am the teacher on the Startup Project. So this program is meant to give the students an experience of what it's like to actually do start a business from the very beginning. It's very much a practical experience type of project, because you can't really teach people entrepreneurship in the same way that you can teach them economics and such as theory. The only way you can learn it is very similar to learning how to ride a bicycle or playing an instrument or becoming an athlete. You can coach people through the experience of doing it, and by making mistakes themselves, that's how they learn how to build a business. So basically what we're asking them to do here is come up with an idea, testing the idea in the field, iterate, and keep moving the project forward until they have enough evidence that they've taken the major risks out of the project. So I think entrepreneurship has always been important, but really it's especially important now, because even if you don't want to start your own business, even if you go into employment, what employers are asking for these days is not just somebody who can fulfill some basic specialized functional needs. They want people who are good at identifying an opportunity, really understanding what that opportunity is, and then putting together all the different elements together that it takes to build that opportunity. And a key thing is people have a need to learn how to deal with uncertainty, because this idea that we can plan a business or something the way that we can plan the construction of a railway is just false. So people need to be able to function intelligently with ambiguity. So people often ask me, when is the best time for students to go through the process of starting a company and something like that? And I think, as I said before, it's very similar to how we learn music or maybe a sport. And I think you can do it at different levels of intensity at different times of your life. So I think in an ideal world, even as children, we would have short experiences of starting a little lemonade stand or selling a few crafts. And then over time, we can start more complicated businesses. But by the same token, I think it's also important for people maybe to spend time working for somebody else in a larger organization, because you can learn a lot more from that. So I think perhaps an ideal career is where you dip back and forth between the two. I think the main advice that I would give anybody who wants to work with startups and stuff like that is two things. Develop at least one core skill that you can bring to the startup. I mean, the ideal one these days is technical development, but it can be finance or accounting. The main jobs that you need to be good at is inventing and developing things, putting them into operation or something like that, and selling. Those are the key skills that you need these days. But then also you have to show yourself that you have the right sort of temperament, tenacity, and character to deal with uncertainty, as I said before, and working collaboratively with other people in what can be a very messy type of situation instead of a very bureaucratic, organized type of situation.